Hi. Well, this is kind of fun and scary. They're cleaning the pipes in my building here in France, and we were advised to, you know, block our drains and not use any water or the toilet or anything during the day. And I can hear some kind of truck outside, and the work started, you know, a little bit before 9 a.m., and I set the alarm because I don't have any appointments until later this afternoon. And my spouse worked all night. He didn't get home until around 5 in the morning, I think. And he was very nervous about this last night, and I said, honey, I will get up and we will agree on how to block the drains and stuff. See, I've got a pot of water here, a heavy pot of water, and I've got plenty of rags and towels ready, you know, and over the toilet and stuff like that. You know, the drains are closed. I do smell an odor, so I've got the window open up front. And what happens is a lot of our neighbors have thoughtlessly put, I'm going to get my handbag and just go downstairs. I'm just wearing a house dress, but I'm not shy, you know, I'm covered in everything. A lot of our neighbors put grease down the drain, and it really blocks things. And I hope you don't do that, because it also makes your drains very dirty and unhealthy. And I've heard that in Switzerland, you know, they absolutely do not allow this. I think in Austria too. Actually, my elevator is not in very good running order, so I hope I can get downstairs okay. Let's see, push the button again. I'm kind of curious to see the truck outside. I've heard that when you vacate your home or apartment in Switzerland, you know, it has to be inspected before you can leave and get your deposit back or whatever, and that it's frequently better to hire professional cleaners because, you know, there can't even be any limescale. See, that's a terrible noise. There can't even be any limescale in your pipes or anything. And I think it's a really good thing because it keeps things really tidy and clean, and it prevents vermin and stuff like that and certain health issues. Yeah, here's the truck, and you can see all of this. I'm not going to really go out on the street. You can see all of this, this tubing and stuff. Well, I'm glad they got here early. And I'm going to go back upstairs in the scary elevator now. See, I definitely don't live in a fancy building or anything, but it's not bad, you know. My spouse complains a lot about Saint-Denis, but, you know, I say, okay, well, we can go live somewhere else, you know. I give him money and stuff, you know, and I'm a pretty supportive wife, you know, I think I am anyway. And, oh, that's terrible. And, but he can't decide where to go because we have a great market here and a lot of really good cultural things, and we're right on the border with Paris, and it's not too far from his job, and he carpools with a coworker. And you know, he doesn't even want to own a car, but he works nights and there's no public transportation to the closed facility where he works. Has very high security. So that's what's going on with me today. I've got a few dishes out from last night, which I didn't really want to put in the dishwasher. It's kind of a strange smell. I've got the window open here in the clutter of the the living room. It's kind of weird, but I'm glad that they're getting it done. All right, this is not newsworthy or anything. And if you've seen a lot of my clips, you've seen a million views of this terrace. You see how cold it is here? Well, you can't see how cold it is here. But it's, since we got back from vacation last month, it's continued to be very rainy in and around Paris. We've had a very wet year this year. It's been a cool year, which is okay with me. I mean, because I don't like heat, and I'm not addicted to sun, and I'm not really a beach person. It was very nice down south. The south, I think, was a little bit drier than usual this year, and it's usually pretty dry down there. But I don't know, you know, the weather. I just don't want another year like 2003 here. We had that killer heat wave. There was just like no escaping it. Heat wave and drought. And I really feel for my contacts in the U.S. who have had to put up with bad weather and stuff this year. And I remember it when I lived in New York in 1988, it was a killer heat wave in New York. I mean, I saw a little sparrow outside on my fire escape, panting in the heat, looking at the lake in Prospect Park, and it didn't even have the energy to fly over to the lake. You know, it was, it just was like panting, and then it fell down. It just fell down dead. You know, and one day I was going to work, and I worked near Grand Central Station in Manhattan at the time, and two people fell on the sidewalk in front of me on my way to work, and you know, people ran over to them and were helping them immediately, but you know, they were just like dropping like flies, and I didn't feel very well myself. And my air conditioner was running a lot in my apartment and not doing all that much good. And I really needed to take a few days off because I wasn't feeling very well in the heat. So I called my job and I said I wasn't feeling very well. You know, I didn't tell them why because they didn't really needed to know. They didn't need to know. But I said, well, I'm going to the doctor this afternoon. He's right in my neighborhood. And I will call you later, and I will send you a copy of, you know, what's going on with me, you know. And I ended up needing about, I would say, 4 or 5 days off during, this was like August of 1988 in New York. And my job just completely went nuts. You know, they're like, whoa, you're not here, you know. I wrote a story about what happened. I was working in a law firm then, and they were pretty unpleasant. It was a pretty unpleasant job. It was a permanent job. And the story is called The Endless Weekend, and I changed the names in it. And I keep looking for the manuscript, and I can't find it. Because I'd really like to read it here on YouTube and share it with you. But I may not have it. You know, my old computer, my husband threw it out, and I don't know. It might be gone. But it was kind of sad about how, you know, when you do the right thing, you know, you're a good employee, you know, everybody likes your work, and you know, you're not feeling well for a few days, and you call up and say, look, I am going to the doctor this afternoon. I will notify you about what's going on with me. And I did, and they just kind of freaked out. I found out later that there was a lottery on how long I would last at that job, because my boss was a really nasty man, and they all got like really angry with me because I lasted so long at that job, and they all lost their bets. You know, they were all like, well, she'll last like 8 weeks or 4 months or something like that, you know, and I was there longer than that, you know, and I couldn't figure out why people were giving me such dirty looks at the job. So please, if you have that sort of thing going on in your workplace, don't do it, you know. I mean, you know, if you know something's wrong, you know, maybe talk to the employee or, you know, try to help them or talk to management and say, you know, this is not cool, you know. Just because the boss is a rainmaker, you know, doesn't mean that... Well, anyway, they were very mobbed up, and they were in with all the politicians in New York, and it was a really scary situation. I was glad to be out of there. You know, I did end up suing them, and twice over all of that. They were very incorrect with me, and I won. And apparently they tried to put a hit on me. So when we settled, I made them meet me on the street, and I had witnesses there. You know, they wanted me to go to the office again, and I said no. You know, I made them pay me on the street, and you know, they never knew where I lived or what my actual phone number was, what my actual address was. You know, these were precautions I used to take in New York. I never deposited any of their paychecks to me in my bank. I used to cash them at their bank and, you know, then you know, put the cash into my own bank or pay my bills directly with that or whatever. And it might seem kind of strange for 1988, but New York was a very scary place, you know. When I moved there in the late 70s, the city was almost bankrupt, and I learned to take a lot of precautions, which I'm kind of happy that I really don't have to do here, now where I live. But whatever. Okay, this video is too long. It's a horrible day. There's the crane going up there. I mean, it's not horrible, but you know what I mean? It's cold, it's wet, and my pipes are being cleaned. Okay, bye.